of my opinion.
I don't really consider Snake a big body.
He is a heavyweight, but when I think of
think of the big characters. Do you okay? How do you feel about DDD?
That's free. I don't care. You want to go DDD? That's free for me, man. It's free for Link.
All right. You like DDD in the game?
Yeah. And K. Rool. And Bowser.
I'll give you another month against playing James as K. Rool, and then we'll have that conversation again.
You see, that's the problem. James is like, he's like Gale if Gale played the character. You just don't know what he's gonna hit you with, and he hits you with it. He doesn't play optimal, man. He just knows how to play his buttons. And I'm over here trying to read this man. But anyways, let's go right into it. Hareta versus Mark the SD King. It's the Rob Ditto that you guys have been clamoring to see. And I say that with sarcasm here. Alrighty.
Hey, I want to see it. I want to see them get bodied. Like, I'm hoping that they'll run at each other and kill each other at 40. That'd be great.
The only interesting thing about this Ditto, in my opinion, is that they both, like, really destroy each other and disadvantage. Like, they edgeguard each other really easily. They combo each other really easily. It just comes down to who's, like, better with, like, this is one of the more skill-based Dittos, in my opinion.
I think it's hilarious because they're both trying to do the Z-drop into forward air on each other at, like, low percents, which is, like, the optimal combo you want to get because that's going to kill your opponent. But it was hilarious to see them both doing it to each other.
I just tell people, look, when you look at Rob as a character, and even maybe possibly in the Ditto, he who holds the gyro holds the neutral, right? But then he who holds the gyro holds the combo. So you kind of have to think about how each player is going to use gyro into their own opportunities, but also, right, the fact they can both use each other's gyro, it's also a big factor.
Oh, trade gyros right there, both players getting hit. Nope.
Use the back air here.
Yeah, SD King just maintaining stage control. Wanting to get hit by another gyro. Run up, down smash with a tech chase. What?
Yeah, very much a situation where either you tech in place or you tech roll. It's a situation you're going to have to choose properly. You want to tech roll back towards the ledge, and even then, you're still at the corner.
I wonder how often both these players are going to lose track of their gyros, just because having two of them on the field can get confusing.
I think the one thing that helps though is they're blue and red respectively, so we can see it's not like cloud limit where if both clouds get limit, you lose track of both clouds.
Oh, Mark the SD King is going to spinny arms his way into a kill, but still that puts Hareta up a full stock. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, wait, heavy, boys.
Moved on. Yeah, we heavy. Rob is a robot. He has some weight. Oh, wow. Double down tilt into the down forward smash. I'm sorry. Not even the kill just yet. 104, though. Really good stuff for SD King, especially for him trying to come back here. Looking at the situations so far, Hareta is very good at close quarters combat versus SD King's doing a pretty excellent job using those lasers. So that's kind of one of those deals, right? Like, yeah, you can space, you can zone, but when it comes down to, right, getting the stocks, getting the percent, the minute Hareta gets in, look at that. Close quarters combat once again, down tilt to the up tilt once more, and he clips him just by the up air. Like I said, it's that close quarters combat that really starts everything off here. You can play the zoning game all you want, you can throw the lasers, but at one point, it becomes a boxing match, and Hareta knows how to box.
Yeah, right, you are. So I hope everyone enjoyed our first game of Rob Dittos. I won't be surprised if this goes to game 3. Because we did start to see a bit of an adjustment from Mark the SD King. But if Hareta can get another explosive start like we saw in game 1, then might just see a 2-0.
Yeah. Oh, thank you so much, DK Rap Vivo, for following 2G Gaming. That's a name. I like it. DK Rap May not like playing fighting DK or Diddy in the Smash, but DK Rap's still a tried classic here, but let's go back to the game here. Like I said, Hareta versus Mark the SD King, starting off again, double gyros off on the stage, never afraid to use the laser SD King, looking for a situation where you can keep Hareta at the corner. I mean, that's what you kind of want to do, right? You want to keep Rob at the corner with your projectiles, especially for SD King, where, like I said, where the zoning becomes a big part of the gameplay. This man with two jabs, read the roll, came back for him. Nice, try to grab the gyro. I respect it though. He knows, you know what, SD King's at the corner. I get this gyro, apply a little bit more corner pressure. Can probably find the stock if I do so properly.
Yeah, the gang. Just putting the brakes on by taking a little bit of damage from the gyro. SD King is on the chase for a Hareta. But Hareta seems to be the one that's playing more evasive against SD King. Okay, good parry, but no punish.
So what a call out there. I mean, what's the one thing you're going to see from coming from each other? Both meeting Rob, right? You know who's going to be going for those up airs for sure. You know who's going to be going for the high recovery. Rob, not afraid to go for the high recovery for good reason.
Yeah, low side B at the ledge. Hareta gonna take a little bit of damage.
Gyro City here. Gyro to Nair or Gyro to Fair. Once again, check this man with two down tilts. Put him at the corner. That's where you kind of want to have your opponent, right? Especially with Rob. Gyro now lining down. Hareta has to be careful on the recovery, but he times it properly where the gyro disappears, comes back. Back air, tying things up 2-2 apiece. Hareta still the master at close quarters combat here, but SD King here looking to finally make sure he's using that spacing game to its full advantage.
Yeah, just the pressure that we're seeing Hareta put with these low percent combos. He's not afraid to just continue to Zair drop Nair in SD King's face. Like, shield, great, I'll cross you up. If not, I'll cross you up again. If I get a shield poke, you know you're gonna eat 50.
For that hard shield grab or out of shield option, please be aware that my aerials do have a lasting hitbox back throw. I like it. Looking to see the high recovery panic. Usually a lot of people like to burn a jump, trying to avoid the bottom of the stage.
Yeah, really Ooh. Smart from Hareta. Did you see, or SD King, did you see that he was able to pick up the gyro on the way up to avoid the gyro combo into up smash, but still. SD King continuing to put on the pressure, taking the stock lead.
Oh, what's yours is mine here, and that's the gyro. Good opportunity, just drop it down there, set up a situation where he goes for a roll, faces the gyro, double down tilt to forward smash here. SD King looking to take the lead here, 119-79. Hareta, excellent job trying to approach here, but facing the gyros. You have to be careful here because that's one thing is where your gyro can become your enemy's gyro, and that's what he wants.
Yeah, you can even see a little bit of Beyblade going underneath that platform as they both connect, and then both gyros exit the stage.
Right thought process. But on the facing there was really, really difficult. So Hareta able to get that stock nonetheless, 119. It's again, like you said, right? Pressure this man with every Zair, every aerial you can, right? Three situations that you'll find yourself in. Which one is going to be your poison? Missed the grab. Okay, we whiffing grabs tonight. Double forward. Hareta is looking for something here. But the roll and the opportunity from the gyro, like I said, you have to be careful. Sometimes your gyro becomes your enemy's gyro. And when it comes to it, Mark the SD King takes game number two, putting it 1-1 apiece. Now, if I can digress, I'm telling you guys all right now. Yes, I was one of those kids who had a Beyblade with the Beyblade video. And I'm telling you right now, it was a sham. Waste of $60 of my parents' money. All you did was
What is this blasphemy? You didn't like Beyblade?
I love the anime, but in hindsight, not as excited as I thought it would be in person. But hey, man, they got my mom and my grandparents to spend $60, and I think that's the W they wanted in the end.
Hey, so you got.
Not me, man, my parents. I was too young. I will admit, I think by the time I was entering high school, Bakugan seemed like an interesting, fun concept.
Yeah, I don't know, I never was into it, so I exited children cartoon phase probably when Bakugan came out.
See, I was one of those people I can admit to you where I had TV on in the background while I did my homework.
Hey, well, here comes another Zaire Nair show on Kalos this time.
It's the stage that everybody wants banned and replaced with small battlefield, but hey.
I thought that was Pokemon Stadium.
Was it? I don't know. I can't. I'm very different. when I saw Twitter, everyone was like, "Yo, man, get rid of Kalos, just give a small battlefield." I was like, "Great, so you guys want?"
Oh, you're right. You're right. That's right.
Yeah, you guys want two. You always want FD with platforms and FD. All right. I can't complain. There are different dynamics in the stages. I want PS1. We all can't have everything, man.
Wait, why do you want PS1?
I like it. Look, I think it's better design-wise, but that's just my opinion. I haven't done all my research yet. It's my opinion off the bat, I would say, but no more opinions here. Let's get right back to the gameplay here. 85% already. Hareta looking with the first stock in his hands.
And getting another grab. That's going to be more damage onto SD King.
Nice. What's more? Corner is mine, but is the corner going to be your demise here? Misses the opportunity here. I still like it. Take the time, trading gyros and trading spaces here. Hareta, he is going to grab his opponent's gyro, which is the right thing you want to do, because you can sit up against them, try to grab it, they have to jab and then go for it. Once more again, Hareta.
They've both shown that they're proficient at that too, so like these gyros at the corner, they both know how to pick them up while they're on the recovery.
It's very, very important. Grab, wait for it. Oh, no. I was gonna say, usually I like to see a rob. A little bit of patience to the mash and then catch his opponent, but I still respect him already. He's up 3 stocks. I'm not the one on the sticks here.
Yeah, unfortunately for SD King, he inputted the sidearms, and that just left him vulnerable enough for Hareta to up smash, whiff, and then up smash again. But here we go. There's some laser battles happening. And the stock pickup from SD King.
Yeah, SD King, you'd be really happy with that stock. Gyros, not so much here. It's Hareta picks up his gyro here. Oh, never mind. Couple corners. I like it though. SD King was looking for an opportunity where he probably could lead that corner carry into offstage into Robo Rotor and then finish it off there. Hareta still 91-67 here. Corner is mine. See, so you get off the stage here, get off the edge. That was the play, but unfortunately carry him off the side, not just it. It's not the curtain call.
And that's understandable that Hirata's gonna throw out like a big move like that at the ledge. We've been seeing SD King jump from the ledge. Typically to pick up the gyro along the way, but Hirata with the spinny arms, move lasts so long, covers a wide amount of space, and with the up air gonna take the set.
Yeah. Looks like SD King was just like, okay, my winning condition here is to jump in the air, do a Z drop Nair a few times, and then kill him at 40 with rage. But he just jumped into an up air and died. It was kind of unfortunate.
I think that's the one thing where Hareta did a really good job of anticipating the common fear of, I don't want to be, you know, below the stage,